John Senko with another edition of the 8U Report. Things are heating up in the America East with conference play beginning in both women's soccer and volleyball. Now let's take a look at the top plays from the past couple weeks. In field hockey, Vermont battled Quinnipiac at home, and it was Kimmy Lizette who gave the Catamounts a 2-1 lead, putting this rising backhander past the Bobcat goalie. Jesus Tudela threads the needle against the Hofstra defense back line, feeding the touch to Fazal Nabi, who scores his second goal of the game against the Pride. Melissa Hummel delivers the perfect ball over the Mount St. Mary's defense to teammate Nikki Beretti, who one-touches it into the net. The New Hampshire Wildcats scored their first goal at home off this perfect free-kick opportunity delivered home by Fazal Nabi. His first of two on the day. UMBC dominated Mount St. Mary's 6-0 on September 12th, and it was capped off by this Lily Rydon header, assisted by Morgan Taylor.
Don't forget to check out America East on social media. Here's Jared with Say What.
As much as we're active in the world of social media, so are our schools. And last week, the University of Vermont had a very creative idea. Spurred on by assistant women's soccer coach Jason Russell and assistant director of athletic communications Pete Estes, the athletic department came up with the idea for fans to vote on the uniform the women's soccer team would wear for their conference opener. The school was able to pencil out 7 different uniform combinations, then scheduled a photo shoot to illustrate all the different choices. They then set up a blog that was dedicated to fan polls and voting. In the first few days the poll was released, they had about 600 views on the blog post and finished with 833 votes. The promotion was pumped out on all the different Vermont social media channels with the hashtag YouPickTheKit. In the spirit of the Vermont contest, we're going to let you pick what we wear on the next AE Report. Want to see us in your school colors? Be on the lookout for a fan poll coming out this week. Vermont is the next stop on our AE road trip. We're visiting all 9 schools in 30 days getting ready for AE hoop season. As part of the road trip, we sat down with UMBC men's soccer head coach Pete Carinji and his son to talk about their relationship and the season.
I've been here my whole life, obviously, with my dad being the coach and seeing every team and remembering everything. And finally, you play for 4 years. We went 3 championships. It was, you're on cloud 9. And all of a sudden, you come back, and it's just kind of different. You think it's going to be the same, but it's kind of cool to see everything still, but it's kind of heartbreaking not to be out there with them because you build relationships, you become a family, and you're still there, but you can't participate. But you try to do whatever you can to help everyone out and to get the best results.
I think it's great to have him back. I think he fits in with the players. Obviously, he had a big role as a player for the last 4 years. The difference between being a coach and being a teammate, he's learning, is an adjustment. But yeah, I think it's fun for me, for sure, and I'm sure he's having fun also with it.
Before, obviously, as a player, you're not going to learn everything about every player. It just won't work like that. But now, learning more and seeing more of his coaching style from a closer up range, it's been good. I mean, he can talk to me more about what I think and kind of more the psychology about it, and we've had a good relationship about it.
You know, no 2 seasons are alike. As great as that team was and as special of a year it was, there's a lot of returning players, so a lot of those guys that we have now have been part of that success. But, you know, you lose just a couple players, and we've lost 3 really good players. We lost 3 players who went on to play pro soccer, and 2 of them were All-Americans. So when you lose that kind of quality at any program, and across the country in any sport, you're always going to have to make some adjustments. So that's what we're trying to do.
It's more of a leadership thing now. I think we have more seniors now, so it's good for all of them to step up. It's not 3 captains, it's just 1 of Mamadou, but there's a lot more leadership, and I feel like even though earlier in the year we might not be getting the results we want, I feel like with those seniors and those leaders, we'll be fine and we'll get back on track.
You know, obviously the America East, I think, is a very good conference. Last year, you know, even though we had great success, it was a very extremely tough conference and could have had another team easily, in my opinion, in the tournament. But yeah, we want to expose our players nationally. We want to play the best teams that we can possibly play, because I think when you do that, one, you're exposing your players to the best, and I think any competitor wants to play against the best players. And just for our conference in general, you know, we want to get out there and we want to show people that the America East can play. We want to show them what UMBC is about.
That'll do it for this edition of the 8U Report.
Be sure to stay up to date with all the action on AmericaEast.tv.